soon today, that's for sure. Probably a quick one, if you can see that water behind me. Manage this one. It's particularly bad out here. Big storm today. There's 8 swimmers down here. And just going to flip it around now with the camera. But the camera's kind of almost blowing out of my hand here. Just to show you what the sea conditions are like. This is the diving board that I showed you the other day. Normally it doesn't look like this, guys. Ireland isn't this bad. But 1 second out, I'll show you what it looks like. Shelter in here out of the wind, so hopefully you'll be able to hear me. So I got that swim done. It was a short one, easy enough to get in but not so easy to get out. One of the things I practiced while I was in there was being calm. Like, the water is really, really rough in there, and it's really good practice for me because, you know, sometimes you have a rough day at work, things aren't going the way you want, things could be, the potential to be quite stressful, but I make a strong effort to stay relaxed when that's the case. And so today when I'm in the water there, it's really good practice for that, just to swim, like, be very relaxed, breathe relaxed, all that kind of thing, no matter what kind of turmoil is going on around you. So the other thing I noticed today, it reminded me of what Jim said to me a couple of weeks ago. There were only 8 people down there swimming today. Normally there's a few more. But it just made me think, Jim said to me that only 5% of the people in the world actually write down their goals and go through any kind of a routine like we do at the moment. So if you're doing this, you're one of 5% of people in the world. So obviously I'd love to get as many of you as possible to become part of that 5%, but just know yourself that, you know, you're so far ahead of most of the other people around you if you're doing that. And again, guys, remember, you know, this isn't for, like, this is for our businesses. This is to grow our businesses. That's why we're doing this. That's why I'm sharing this stuff. So, those 3 things, just, you know, use what's around you to try and practice things. Like, you know, for me today it was like staying calm and not getting stressed in the water. Remember that you're one of those 5%, and remember that this is all about growing your business.
I had to stop off here again because as I started running, I just thought of something I should have said. So what I was talking about earlier on there, when I was in the water and, you know, the stressful situation and just trying to relax and breathe and stay calm and keep the muscles relaxed. Many of you have said to me that you feel under pressure when you're in a phone situation or in a networking situation, you're trying to make a sales call or a sales meeting. And I think it's an important lesson to be learned from what happened to me today in the water or what I tried to do. So when you're under a pressurized situation, you need a really kind of simple mantra just to get you through it. So for example, if you've been role-playing your sales calls, you might have, you know, 10 or 15 things that are in your practice, and it's very hard to remember 10 or 15 things when you're under pressure. In fact, you pretty much can't. If you're under severe pressure, you can't do that. So what you should do, what I do when I'm in the water there, is just have a couple of things that you're going to say over and over to yourself as you go through that process. And for me, it's just breathe and relax the muscles, breathe and relax the muscles, breathe and relax the muscles. By the time I finish the breathing relaxed bit, I've forgotten about the muscles, and then I need to go back to the breathing and then back to the muscles. So an idea if you're on the phone would be just breathe and listen, breathe and listen, breathe and listen. And so it'll slow things down for you. It'll make sure that you are way more relaxed and you'll be able to have a better conversation. Make sure you listen to your prospect. Whatever it is works for you. You know, 1 or 2 or 3 words that just keeps you on track and you can put up in front of you on your board or computer, whatever it is. So maybe that will help you, and I'll talk to you later, guys. Thank you.